gerecken sich jeden zum
Grabesfreude,
stark zufrieden mit
Grabesfreude.
Jeder Ringer will seine Heilig in dem
Schabbos. Good night, Shabbos, dear friends. It's Erev Shabbos Kodesh Parshas Ekev. Rabbi Avraham Genachovsky, the late and revered Mashgiach of Chabin, related the following incident. A Holocaust survivor arrived to America shortly after liberation, seeking a livelihood, but was struggling with the language and culture, was limited with options. Luckily, he saw a sign that the shul's neighborhood shul was looking for a shamus, so he decided to approach them. They interviewed him. They were impressed with his self-confidence, his wittiness, and decided to sign and hire him. One of the board members asked him, "But you do speak English?" And he replied in the negative, saying that unfortunately, coming from Poland, he hasn't spoken and wasn't efficient in English. So therefore, due to that, they decided, because the shul needed a English-speaking shamus for the community, they did not hire him. Without choice, he decided to purchase a used pushcart and began to sell some odds and ends and trinkets on the corner. Business was lucrative, so he expanded hiring a young fellow to manage an additional pushcart. The success of his endeavor continued until he had to put a string of pushcarts throughout the city. As he decided that it was time to close the pushcarts and open up a large department store, business was booming. He was doing very well and successful. The simple pushcart had now become a large conglomerate. At the closing of one of his major transactions involving the purchase of a new large business, he was asked to read and sign the contract. The man gave the contract to him, and he passed it on to his secretary to read prior to signing. The businessman and lawyer on the other side of the table were baffled. They couldn't believe it, that a man of this stature, who was able to build a business, such a large business, an empire, yet cannot read English. He was so excited and with fervor, he got up and slammed on the table. And he said, "Let me tell you something. If I had spoken English, I would today be washing the floors in the shul." Rav Avraham Genachovsky concluded and said, "We find that the Rebbeinu Shalom specifically find in this week's parsha how we constantly must bench and bless HaKadosh Baruch Hu and thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu, V'rachta Hashem Elkecha, V'chalta V'sabata, V'rachta Hashem Elkecha. When there's an abundance of goodness, we always have to thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu. But it's very fascinating that we find one of the brachas that we say daily, whenever we eat or drink, we say the Boirei Nefashos. And when we say Boirei Nefashos, we thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu for the creation of humanity, of the creation. But we also say Boirei Nefashos Rabbeis V'Chesroinon, along with the deficiencies. So the Shulchan Aruch of the Torah tells us that deficiencies means that HaKadosh Baruch Hu completes whatever we're missing in our life. The deficiency, HaKadosh Baruch Hu completes that, whatever we need. But the Rashba argues, and he says no. He says, we thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu for actually specifically for what appears to us that is deficient in our lives. Because one never knows, first of all, what the outcome of this of deficiency that you are blessed with. But as well, by recognizing and when the deficiency within you, you appreciate the goodness and what you do have. It's so significant in our lives to recognize and appreciate everything that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives us, along with Chasroinon, because we don't know the outcome, but it also gives us and enhances the appreciation of what HaKadosh Baruch Hu does give us in our life. A good Shabbos.
Jeder einer will sein heilig in dem
Schabbeskoide.
Jeder einer will ach heilig in dem Schabbeskoide. In dem Schabbeskoide.